to say that this ring has been unfairly invaded. No, he hasn't. He's actually stopped the fight.
Tell me about the Pat Gaddell fight, the first fight in 86 when he became British champion. I mean, clearly then, everything must have been right.
He did train. He trained really hard and he really believed in it. And it was the easiest one to train for. I used to pick him up and take him home. And he did actually train, did everything that he wanted, sparred, and he was so confident. He wouldn't hear of defeat, and I knew Najib Dao as well as any of his family, and I knew he really meant it, and my pals didn't think he was going to win, and I said, don't be surprised if he doesn't do him in the first round, and we tried to stop him in the first round, and if not to stop him, to hurt him that bad that Najib would win, and it came off, just one of those things.
Daho's reward for his one-round demolition of Cowdell was a crack at the IBF World Super Featherweight title against Aussie hardman Barry Michael, an experienced and durable fighter, but a man Daho had once beaten back in 1979. But despite this psychological boost, Daho was in deep against a very competent champion. But still, it was a dream come true, from the small hall to the big stage and a chance of fame and glory in front of his hometown fans, who turned out in numbers to roar him on.
Barry Michael was a terrific fighter, and most people didn't recognise how good he was. But then Barry McGuigan didn't fancy fighting.
What do you remember specifically about the Barry Michael fight?
Najib's bravery, really. He had little else but bravery going for him after about the fifth round.
Well, already there, feeling a bit like a winner, isn't he? Family all on his side, obviously, and Barry Michael's got his wife, and that's about all, and a pretty flag carrier there, Eileen from Liverpool. I'm afraid he didn't give her a glance, because Sandy, who partly manages Barry Michael's watching, there's Barry Michael there wearing the Australian rules jersey,
and it is, of course, the International Boxing Federation, the first time that that particular body has had a championship fight recognised or taking place in this country, because the Boxing Board of Control have not officially joined that group yet. So if styles count, these two should have a humdinger. It'll be head-to-head stuff, I promise you that. They fought in Wales, and between them they only got £520, and I can tell you this is the biggest purse this afternoon they've ever earned. It's a big one. And Daho won that fight on points. First round, I mean, having had that incredible success with Pat Cowdell, there's no doubt that Daho is going to try and get off early. But 12 rounds course, it has been cut to 12 rounds, which is now the standard in this country. The IBF agreed to do that. They normally have 15. He's never been on the deck, Barry Michael. That's a tremendous record, but the way he's taking punches here, it could happen. Very popular fighter in Manchester, Daho. He's caught nicknamed the Casper Kid. For a while, the new manager, Jack Trickett, who sort of transformed him, as it were, so they should have called him the Disco Kid when he started boxing, because he didn't really train that well. Side, and he's taken advantage of any encouragement going his way in the opening round, Daho. Amazing how Barry Michael who has actually fought right up to welterweights over the 10 stone mark and is now down to 9 stone 2 and a half, almost a featherweight, which is 9 stone. They're not larking about in the opening round, I tell you that, in the coming up the last minute of this round, Jim.
Now this is a good start from Daho too. I think the main thing he has to do, try to keep the Mike on his back foot and keep his own elbows nice and tight to his ribcage, because Michael seems to, his plan seems to be to spend the first couple of rounds banging about the body. All the powerful punches Michael has thrown so far have been towards the ribcage, but a very good start from Daho.
Philadelphian referee here, Rudy Battle. So it's a real good start, this is no doubt about it. As Jim Watt said, it's a good start by Daho. But he is Barry Michael, from what we've seen of him, he takes his time getting off. There you are, there's the statistics. As I said, he hasn't been on the deck, and still managing to keep those gold teeth intact. A great talker, he talks about being a great motivator, Barry Michael. Goes around and does a bit of public speaking, knows the statistics of the fight game, he knows the background. Najib Daho, most of those losses actually came early on in his career. He was bowled over by Ken Buchanan, former lightweight champion of the world, but well, that could happen to anybody with a fighter of that quality. So Ernie Fossey from London, they've got in the corner. They've Kenny Daniels, his normal trainer, Jack Trickett on the outside, they're adding his little percentage worth of advice.
Second down, round two.
Into the second round, and almost before the bell had gone away there, they were at it. I told you that that's the way these guys have to fight. There's no hit and run among these two. It's got to be a stand and trade fight, whatever happens. In world terms, we've never kidded anybody that they're great names, but it had to be a really hard fight, because both of them are very experienced. You don't often get that. Sometimes get championship fights before they paid their dues, but these fellas have done it. Yes, he's a good body puncher, Barry Michael. He likes to bring the hands down and wear the opponents down a bit, the old wars of attrition. Well, there's going to be some bumps and bruises of battle, I think, soon, Jim, don't you?
Yeah, it's going to be a hard afternoon for both of them. Michael's physically very strong. You can see inside the leverage he gets into the punches, even when he's off balance. He's good arm strength. He's a very strong little man. When you're boxing someone who's not known as a smart performer, the best thing you can do is keep him on his back foot. Don't let him get set. And Daho will have to do that with Michael. He can't allow Michael to dictate things to do.
Well, it seems as though Daho's corner have been telling him to work on that straight left, because Michael doesn't defend himself that well, and eats a few of those on the way in. But no, he slipped those, didn't he? That shows the old experience coming in. A little bit of bloodied nose there on Daho. As I said to Jim Watt there, it's obviously going to be a few scars showing in a minute, because with this rough type of contest, it's inevitable. So half a minute to go then in the second.